The word safe means protected from or not exposed to danger or risk, or not likely to be harmed or lost, unless you're on the SCP wiki, in which case it means not likely to escape containment. Today, let's talk about how you're probably wrong about object classes. The image you're looking at right now contains 25 separate object classes, and is not entirely comprehensive. It was compiled by Antizar of Quers, and it is actually useful since it's a flowchart. You start here, and you know, you can move throughout the flowchart to find out if your object would fit into an esoteric class. The answer is no, your object probably doesn't fit into an esoteric class. In fact, I'll make a point right now, there is no good reason to use an esoteric class unless you absolutely have to. And I say this as someone who personally has done it more than once, but we're going to go through the object classes that aren't esoteric in just a second, but just to make a point, esoteric means anything that isn't safe, Euclid, Keter, Thaumiel, explained, neutralized. We'll get this out of the way early on. The word Keter, as used by the SCP Foundation, I'm pronouncing it Keter because that's how I've always pronounced it, and that's how most English language speakers have begun to pronounce it, and therefore it becomes valid as a pronunciation because people pronounce it that way. If enough people pronounce something one way, it becomes a valid possible pronunciation for it, which is how language works. But the actual word is Hebrew, and it's supposed to be pronounced Keter. So if someone does say Keter, they are not wrong, and really have a better claim to being right than I do. But I'm not here to tell you about how you're not wrong. See, the real issue with object classes in a more general sense is that they don't, at least the core ones, don't really communicate a whole lot of information to an audience. And object classes, at least the core basic object classes, are generally about the difficulty of containment. In fact, they're mostly about containment. The original three, Safe, Euclid, and Keter, are only about containment. Thaumiel is still about containment, though it's about it in a different way, and obviously neutralized or explained or decommissioned, which decommissioned is still esoteric, but it's a little bit more common, I think, than most. But decommissioned is sort of a, in a way, a roundabout way, still about containment. See, a lot of site-based authors, or even just well-read readers, will look at object classes, and, you know, when a new person comes along, they'll be like, is it safe? How dangerous is it? And they'll go, it's not about danger, it's about containment. Which, to me personally, betrays a little bit of lack of self-awareness. Because think about it. If your base object classes are Safe, Euclid, and Keter, what reasonable person wouldn't think that safe means safe? And you acting all smug and superior about it isn't going to change the fact that this classification system is just bad. Safe doesn't mean what it actually means. Euclid is, you know, what does Euclid mean? Whenever anyone hears the word Euclid, the only thing they think about is Euclidean geometry, or for the SCP Wiki, non-Euclidean geometry, even though they use it often in a way that doesn't make any sense. And Keter just means crown, which, interestingly enough, probably means that Keter was supposed to be the top level, right? It's the crown, it's the highest level of in Kabbalah, Keter is the crown at the top of the Sephiroth, of the Tree of Life. So it's like, it's funny because now they're like, super Keter. No, Keter is the top. It is, or at least it's supposed to be. It's not anymore because there are other, people want to throw in an esoteric class that's essentially super Keter and be like, ha, now I'm important because my SCP that I wrote is much, much harder to contain than anything else. And to be completely and totally honest with you, Keter is the only word that actually has any sort of deeper meaning to it. Euclid is named after a person, safe is a very basic word, whereas Keter, at least in Kabbalah, is supposed to be like the most hidden of things and completely incomprehensible to man, which, you know, sort of fits in with the SCP Foundation's usage of the word. But the idea of each of these object classes, they have a particular purpose. So we're going to go over those particular purposes really quickly because it's not too difficult to understand. Safe, again, isn't about the danger of the object. It's about how easy it is to contain. If you have a magic wand, it doesn't matter if that magic, if you point that magic wand at a person, but a person has to pick it up first, a person has to be holding it, then point it at another person and speak a word that only you know, and it shoots nuclear fire out of the other end, it doesn't matter that it just created a thermonuclear detonation and destroyed the surrounding 6 square kilometers, if you can put it in a box and absolutely nothing will happen, it doesn't matter how dangerous it is as a weapon, it's safe. Now, if people find out about that object and come in and try and steal it, there could be an argument made to raise it to Euclid because there is more requirements to try and keep it in containment. But the object itself, without anyone knowing about it, would just be safe. And that moves us into Euclid. Now, Euclid is generally the baseline for any humanoid entity because living things require extra levels of attention. You have to feed them, you have to care for them, you have psychological care, all these other things. And if they have an ability, you have to make sure that they don't willingly activate it if it's a willingly activated thing. And if it's not willingly activated, you have to basically keep their emotional health in check and that kind of thing. So if it's alive and it's anomalous, it's almost certainly Euclid. There are maybe a few cases where you could argue that it's safe, but almost certainly, at least, I should say, not Euclid exclusively, at least Euclid. And Keter is reserved for objects that are nearly impossible to contain. Now, this could be very, very difficult to contain, like requires a set of very specific containment procedures, or regardless of what you do, say you could put it in a box, and that's the only real way to keep it in containment, it still sometimes activates, or it still sometimes does the anomalous thing, and can use that ability to get out of containment. So that's it, basically. Each of these three object classes covers the basics. Either it's you can put it in a box and nothing happens, or you put it in a box and you have to care for it a little bit, or you put it in a box and you constantly have to pay attention to it and care for it or else it'll escape. Those are the three object classes, Safe, Euclid, and Keter. Now there's a fourth object class that's used, I'd say, probably more than any other esoteric classes, and it's technically not esoteric, it's one of the standard object classes because it's just become so common, and that one is Thaumiel. Now Thaumiel isn't necessarily about how easy or difficult it is to contain it, but rather about how it is used for containment of other anomalies. It has to be itself anomalous and also be useful and used to contain other anomalies. And that's it. And to be honest with you, I think Thaumiel gets a little overused. Like, people are like, treat it as though it's super Keter. Remember, everyone, Keter is the top when it comes to difficulty of containment. There isn't anything more difficult to contain than Keter. Saying something is super Keter, or an object class that is more difficult to contain than Keter, would be like saying something can be very perfect. It's a binary thing. It either is or it isn't. It can't be very perfect. That's not a real possibility. And there are two other object classes which are used a little bit, let's say not often, but probably more often than any of the other esoteric classes, and that is explained and neutralized. And both of those are very simple. Explained is exactly what it says on the tin. It is an object that is no longer considered anomalous. You know, 100 years ago, a highly radioactive substance would be considered probably a Keter SCP object. It would be considered anomalous. We wouldn't understand how it works or what it is, but today it's perfectly understood through science, so it's explained. This is just an idea to allow for some history of the Foundation to be shown to the reader, because essentially what you're doing is you're saying stuff like, those old objects existed, and this is what the Foundation was like back then. Anytime you see an explained SCP, it's usually, I should say anytime, but it's usually an effort to go into the history of the SCP Foundation. Now, neutralized is completely different. Neutralized is an SCP object that is no longer anomalous, because the SCP Foundation or someone else, it's usually the SCP Foundation, but sometimes it's other people, have actually either eliminated it or removed its anomaly. Now, the best example of that is if you had a reality warper that was an SCP object and you just killed them somehow. You shot them in the head. Let's say you put them in a room with a bunch of Scranton reality anchors and you killed them. That would be a neutralized anomaly. Anyway, that's it. Thank you for watching. If you liked it, scroll down, hit the subscribe button, and then hit the notification bell next to that so you'll be notified as soon as I upload my next video. And if you want to continue to support this kind of content, head on over to patreon.com/dcimmerian and pledge at any level. It's nice to know that I'm not alone out here. I'll see you all again on Thursday. Oh, and you, Aiden? I think it's Aiden, right? Yeah. I'm going to need you to hit the subscribe button. You skipped it. You listened to me say hit the subscribe button and then you didn't do it. So do it right now. Don't worry about the Patreon right now, but, you know, think about it when you get to 18. That's it.